doing the things that I never would know. Treat me like what's easy. Don't get.
So the previous video didn't have as much recognition I was hoping for it to have, so I'm gonna make another video that definitely does not talk shit about the game. So as you might know, there is an event currently going on right now that is called Carnival, which only happens once a month for a limited time. In the Carnival, you can get yourself a golden ticket and play various mini games that has a prize. There are at least 3 prizes at the end and they have a random chance of dropping. You can increase the chance of dropping the best prize by pleading on a record time. Well, you can have fun by doing these carnival games, but the real deal is the Ringmaster.
He's just standing there, menacingly!
The man has many names. Some call him Ringmaster, the most calls him Ring Scammer. It is due to the way the Ringmaster gives prizes. There are different rings that gives different ability. The One Ring, which turns the loser invisible. Ring of Force, which explodes blocks as it destroys them. And many more. The Ringmaster doesn't just give you a ring. He randomly picks one. That is why it is most likely to be a ring you already had if you had done the Ringmaster before. But I haven't, so I'm getting a ring in this video. There are 10 steps before getting a ring. Some steps can be easy, some steps can be expensive, some steps can be time consuming, and some steps might be crazy. The Ringmaster is crazy, so let's start this video before it gets lengthy. It started off easy with breaking 4 blocks. Catching over 1,000 pounds of fish. The next step was breaking 1 block. It took no time and I went for my next step. My next step was easy since 3000 rarity is really fast to harvest.
After all those easy steps, I was pretty confident that I would get a ring pretty fast. Until... oh lord, 10 Geigers. It's going to take a long time. Geigers, after you use them, you get a irradiated effect, which stops you from using another Geiger. The irradiated effect stays for 30 minutes, which means 10 Geiger finds are 300 minutes. That's 5 hours. So I had to stay in front of my screen every time. So I bought around 3 Geigers and a Geiger charger. That means I spent around 112 world locks and I started doing the Geigers. Also, there's an item called hot chocolate, which removes the irradiated effect immediately. It took me an entire day to finish this, so I'm hoping I'll get an easy step right after. Oh, fuck. Yeah, at this point, most people just gives up, but for content, I just decided to take it. I finished my daily quest and my role quest for 2 grow tokens. And it was already late, so I went to sleep for the next day. Next day, the daily quest was over 32 world locks. Yeah, I spent over 30 world locks for the role quest too. And finally, I was finished. All of those took around 68 world locks to finish. Just one close, but I missed. Anyways, time for my next step. Yes, finally, we got an easy one. I speedrun the rest of the steps and I'm just gonna show you guys because this video is already 6 minutes long and I don't want you guys to waste your time.
Young Metro, don't trust you, I'm gonna shoot. Beautiful morning, yeah, the sun of my morning, baby.